It's a defunct old building back in the mid-90s. No one wanted to see it. It was a hunting junk. No windows left in it. Derelict building. And a local council called it an eyesore. But the owners wanted $60 million for it. It was clearly worth that. The trust worked out, you and I have now too. I trust, at least. You and I worked out that time is more important than what? Time is more important than money. He said to the two owners of this property, listen, I'm giving you $60 million. I'll give you $70 million. But in exchange, I need 18 months as an option. Was that very clever, yes or no? Say the word genius. Come on, yell it out. It was genius. Because here's what happened next. Put down a nominal amount of money, $100,000, to control a $60 million asset. Is that clever? Is that a little genius? Here's what happens next. Trump walks off to the council. He puts in a permit, a development permit, to the council. He says, listen, I want to build a massive hotel on this site. 563 rooms. The council says, sure. Council gives consent to approval. 14 months later, question, think carefully right now. Did Trump settle on the property? Yes or no? Say hell no. Come on, say hell no. No way. Because if he did, he'd have to owe stamp duty, he'd have to incur massive amounts of interest from day one. He'd probably owe the National Australia Bank maybe 30, 40 grand a month in interest. Is that fair enough? Yes or no? That's not intelligent. He'd be liable for $60 million worth of debt. He probably would need to have to inject maybe $10, $15 million cash to help with that. Trump took an option over the property, and 14 months later, he had an approval for a hotel. Was that clear?
Yes.
Brilliant. He sold it to someone you've probably heard of before. It's called the Hyatt Hotel Chain. That's what's sitting there today. Was that a good deal? Well, here's what happened next. He optioned $70 million, and he sold it to the Hyatt, not for $70 million, folks, but for $105 million. Now tell me, what's the difference between 70 and 105 million? What is it? 35 what? $35 million cash in a little bit over 1 year. Are you with me, folks? Now, clearly there is something here. There's got to be something in options. If Trump, Kiyosaki, Templeton all use this technique, there must be something here. And what's cool about today is that we now brought it to Australian shores. I've been working this technique for 9 years now, nearly a decade of my life. And I can tell you one thing, it is incredibly fruitful. Wildly profitable. You've probably heard of names like Stockton, Osterland, Divine, Dilfer. We work with all. And this is where the game is won. I trust I've got your attention now. So in 1996, my bank, $35 million cash. So how do you go from being broke with $900 million in debt to being worth $7.4 billion today? You use options. All making sense so far? Say the word garbage. Garbage. I'll make sure you got that. Let's get to it. So what is an option? How does this thing work? You probably want to get some notes right now. An option is literally this. It's a legal agreement that gives us time. Real simple terms. Doesn't have to be flash. It's just an agreement. It's a legally binding agreement that gives us time. And the time is typically between 12 and 18 months. Why do we need time? We're not going to sit around and wait for the market to improve, hope on a limit of prayer that it gets better. I subscribe to the same principle as Robert Kiyosaki yesterday. I think it's going to get worse before it gets better. Thank God. You want to keep your debt, your exposure, minimal. The whole renovation thing, I'm telling you now, the whole thing real estate with lots of debt, we need to change tax. We need to make large lumps of money and pay down debt quickly. Are you with me so far? This is the technique here, folks. It's an agreement. And at that time, we're going to utilize that time, go off to the council and get a permit, get an approval for something else. You might look at those three old houses on the street corner and go, you know what? That would make a terrific service station. Or For if people pass those couple of old houses for, that would make a great medical centre or a veterinary surgery. Or that would make a great apartment block with some retail downstairs. If people pass that old dusty ship all the time, you know what? On that lane road, it'd make great old people's retail. Five eaters, barbecues, and all, sneaky head, 14 links, something like that. Are you pleased so far? This is enormous, folks. I want you to get the full grasp of this. So, how does it work then? Let's have a quick look. It's about control versus ownership. I want to be able to make profits and then go buy real estate debt-free. Is it a smart way of putting it? Yes or no? Who cares where interest rates go from that point forward, right? It doesn't really matter. Or if we're going to buy a property and it's worth $500,000, let's bring $350,000 cash and get our tax savings on $150,000 tomorrow. Is that a smart approach? Yes or no? Would you agree that it's a smart way of doing it? Good. Write this down. You're going to need between 8 and 12 hours of a week to get this started. That might be 2 nights after you put the kids to bed, that might be 3 nights or Saturday afternoon. You'll need about 8 to 12 hours to get started. Per week. Write this down as well. A lot of you don't realise this just yet. You are literally one deal away from retirement. Think about that, folks. We don't have to be drunk, but if we're pulling an extra $200,000 a year for transaction, or $80,000, or $90,000, or $145,000, does that get us a whole lot faster than we want to go? That's what this is about. Control. I don't want to own stuff unless I own it outright. That's the objective. Let's keep moving. So how does the process work? Great question. Here's a live transaction. This is put together by a couple called Darren and Teresa. The property was optioned at $1 million. With a development approval in place, we've got 460 square metres of retail downstairs. We've got 310 square metres upstairs for office space. Now the property is worth an enormous amount more. Are we all clear on this so far? So the word garbage. I want you to follow this. This is brilliant. At $1.7 million, that's what the value of sale is worth. Now the value is quite conservative. Yes? Absolutely. At $1.7 million, you can see there's $700,000 of gross profit. Right? You might be seeing the same thing on that. And I want to try and read your mind to you. You're probably sitting there going, this all makes sense, but who the hell would give you